All right, so first we are going to prep this prosthetic by painting the packs before we put it on the face, because that is a lot more efficient, don't you think? So again, if you forgot, our packs paint is basically acrylic paint and prosade, and prosade is medical adhesive. And we're just painting, just getting that all covered so we seal all of this foam latex so we can paint on top of it without any paint getting sucked inside and wasting product. I would say this is my favorite part of doing special effects makeup. It's always the painting that's fun. And when you work with PAX paint, it's just kind of good to wear gloves, because since it's a medical adhesive and acrylic paint, it'll really stick to you and it's kind of hard to get off. So all right, now we're done. We're gonna go ahead and let this dry so we can put it on Robbie's face.
Hey Cassandra, what are you making me into now?
An alien.
How the heck are you gonna do that? How the heck am I gonna do that?
I don't know. Good luck.
Okay, so what's the first step?
All right, first, we're going to put your hair back into a wig cap. Two fingers up. Put your fingers up. Because the prosthetic itself is a little bit bigger, so when we glue it down, it needs a bald head to be glued down to.
And I'm losing my ears?
Yeah, I just cut the hole in. When you do this, you always want to cut just a little smaller than the ear itself.
Ah! No kidding.
So you can just stick it behind while you're gluing. So after we finish with our ear holes, we're gonna go ahead and put Prosade on the edge parts. Get a blow dryer just to warm it up so it's all nice and tacky, and then pull it down and anchor it to our face. All right, so here's the prosthetic. We put the ball cap down so it has something to glue to up at the top. And it's a little bit bigger than our other ones where they just met right here at the forehead, but our forehead isn't right here for this one. It's way back here. So we're gonna put this on, you know, protect, you know, his hair from glue and all that. And so we're just gonna glue along these lines and easy. So next we're gonna blend our edges with our thicker Prosade, the Prosade cream, and just make this all look like it's a part of him. All right, so now with our portable airbrush, we're going to paint these stripes to give him some more detail instead of just being a flat alien. And we're just going to hand paint now with our alcohol paint. Now I'm adding some pink alongside the blue. We're just adding some more depth and colors. Then we're gonna take our detail brush and start flecking on colors onto the skin. So we're doing all this detail painting and the stripes, but what's gonna make this pull into one is gonna be when we do the white.
Look, Lord Voldemort.
And now I'm gonna go prepare the eyeballs and make them so we can stick them in Robbie's face. All right, so just stay here for a little bit, okay? Just like this.
Okay.
All right, so our alien prosthetic came with some eyeballs that we kind of have to cut out ourselves. So I'm gonna show you how we're gonna do that on camera.
There we go.
And here they are. All right, now we're gonna paint them to give them some color. So we're just gonna take acrylic paint. This is just from Michaels. You can take any acrylic paint, and we're just gonna put them on the inside, because when you paint the inside, it tends to look more smoother than if we paint it on the outside. Just so we can get the rest of these little spots, we're gonna go ahead and add the second layer so it's nice and opaque. Now that these are fully painted, we're gonna go ahead and slap these onto Robbie's head. All right, Robbie, here they are.
Wow. Am I gonna be able to see in these?
Definitely not.
Oh. Okay, I just spit on you. I'm sorry. Okay, insert the eyes into my eye holes.
Okay.
Oh no. Yep, I definitely can't see at all.
Okay, now we're gonna add some ears. This is the last touch. And we're done.
Wow, it looks... Actually, I can't really see how it looks. Oh no, I gotta sneeze. Oh God, oh God. Is it gonna fly off?
No.
It's really staying on, isn't it? Wow, good job. I honestly don't know how I'm gonna one up this, especially going in blind. Literally, I'm going in blind. I'm gonna be blind when I do this.
Where's the camera?
Well, I guess now it's time for me to try and recreate this look on Tori. Okay, Tori Dobransky, are you ready for me to turn you into an alien?
I think so. I don't know anymore.
I took the eyes out so I could actually see while I'm doing this. I still have very limited, I could probably see about 1/3 as well as I normally can. It's okay, I can still do your makeup like a pro. So, the first thing I'm gonna do is put your hair back and then put it into a bald cap. This bald cap is not as nice as the one that Cassandra used on me. Hers was like $20 or something. This one's from like the Halloween store, and I think it was like $3 or something. It was really cheap. Okay, looks pretty good. I might just hide your ears.
That's fine. I don't need ears.
We don't even need ears. And then like always, I'm gonna use some eyelash glue. This has a little bit of red in it because I mixed it with some fake fake blood a while ago. This is some really cheap eyelash glue. Wait, no, this isn't. I also stole this from my girlfriend. But you can use really cheap eyelash glue. At least that's what I do. To just kind of adhere the ball cap onto her face. And then I actually went out and got even more gumball containers. These were like $10 for all of them. It came with 150 pieces, but we're only using two. These would be about $1 if you bought them in a gumball machine for two of them. And then we're just gonna go ahead and somehow adhese these to your eyes like that.
Oh no, I can see out of a pinhole.
Then I'm gonna get some of this $5 scar wax. You can get this at a Halloween store. The intern loved this, and I know that you're gonna love this as well. Just really blend this into the rest of your face.
I look good.
Do I look beautiful?
You look really good.
Oh, stop it.
Now we're gonna paint Tori green using this green, it's just a cream makeup. You can get this for like $1 at Walmart during Halloween time.
One of us, one of us.
Really got all the fine details. We're done. Wow, you look fantastic.
Really?
I mean, yeah. Well, let's show Cassandra and see what she thinks. Okay, Cassandra, so what do you think about my makeup? Did I do a good job?
She looks like a very wet chameleon.
What I said.
Okay, so basically, I used the same method that I used on the intern, where I just got the little gumball containers and I used scar wax to adhere them to her face. Obviously, it's not as practical as this because I can just take my eyeball out and I can actually see. We're talking like $5 for the ball cap, $1 for the makeup, and $1 for the gumball containers. So under $10.
All right, so this prosthetic, altogether, I think with the sculpt and then also these eyeballs and the ball cap, probably about like $100. And then we used our alcohol paint, which is another $100. And a little bit more cream paint, which was probably about $50. So this one was probably about right around our range. The other ones have been $300.
Whoa! So this is $300 versus $10. Wow! There's really a diminishing returns when it comes to aliens. You know, this is like 30 times the price and, you know? Honestly, Cassandra, yours look way better than mine. I don't know how you do it. This is fantastic.
They look the same.
Wow, this is awesome.